So why are these price rises happening? And why do I really think that if you want to buy anything, now is the time to do it? Hi everyone. As we all know, prices are going up. There's price increases. Inflation around the world is going through the roof after the whole COVID effect. And it's getting increasingly more difficult to buy into these luxury brands, particularly if you're starting out, you want to get your first bag. You want it to be a higher up brand and you feel that you're being squeezed out, you're being priced out. Well, I'm going to talk about all of it, why I think it's happening, ways around it, and also I have got some absolute corkers in this video, some amazing bags, and with all of them, and I have never had this before, ever, on YouTube, I bought all of them with a 15% off. And I only ever normally get 10% off. So this is the first time I've been given a 15% off coupon code, and it works on Givenchy, Balenciaga, Jordan sneakers, loads of brands. And I would say, even if you don't like anything in this video, go and shove stuff in your shopping cart, use that code and see what it works on, because it works on so many brands on Farfetch, and I don't profit from it, by the way. But the whole code feeds into what we're going to talk about in this video, and I'm going to show you each of the bags, which are from higher top tier brands, brands that do have price increases, but I want to say that they're incremental and they're small enough that they're not always massively noticeable. They're not like Louis Vuitton, who a couple of weeks ago had a price rise, and I know YouTube went crazy over it because the price rise was so much. And you know, also Chanel, the classic flap in the large size, that bag's now over £7,000. I never thought that it would get that high. I don't know why, I thought it would plateau at around 6,000, which is like a lot. I can see that bag going upwards of 10,000. I don't see those price rises ever stopping or ever slowing down. So we'll discuss that. Before I do, there's a bit of a haul in here. And as I mentioned, everything I've bought with that 15% off, including my top and also my trousers that you can see here. If you use the code, don't be surprised if your things arrived packaged slightly differently. So as you can see here, I'm unwrapping the trousers, and also I'm unwrapping a banger of a bag that is in the £600 mark, which if you want to get into your first bag, this is one of the best. I've spoken about this bag before and I'm going to talk about it again in a spring color because it's a brilliant bag. But that bag also has come wrapped differently, and that's kind of how it works on Farfetch. It's like Farfetch is like a platform and the stuff on it is all sold by different boutiques globally. I'm going to start with Balenciaga, a really iconic brand, and one that I am surprised is not more expensive than it actually is. And I massively think with any of these, with any brand, but with the ones I'm going to show you, if you have ever been tempted to buy into any of these, now is the time. I wanted to try the Hourglass bag, so I wanted to try it in black, but then I saw this, which is the sparkly, silvery, glittery version of it. This, if you're into, you know, the Prada bag covered in crystals, if you like that, but that's quite expensive, very expensive, and if you're thinking I'm not going to spend that money but I like the concept of something that's a bit sparkly, I love this. The way that this is, it kind of looks a bit like glitter, but it's not like cheap glitter stuck on the bag. It's actual sparkle that's inside the fabric. Just gonna quickly cut in here to say that I'm gonna show you now what fits in each bag, and I'm working with some sunglasses in their case, two phones. This is the Samsung Flip, the iPhone in the 13 mini. I've got some powder here, a makeup brush, lipstick, hand cream, oil absorbing sheets, and a card holder. And you can hopefully see that despite the shape of the bag, the way it curves up underneath, it actually fits all of those items really, really quite comfortably. Despite the fact it's metallic-y, this I think will go with any outfit, as I hope I'm demonstrating here, just with like the outfit that I'm wearing at the moment. But even with sneakers, this goes. I almost, in a way, think I prefer it to this, but then this is so classic as well. I really think the benefit to buying black bags is they go with everything. And it doesn't matter if your style changes over the years, you can still pull out a black handbag and still make it work. You know, my style's really changed over the years, and it's the black bags I have that I reach for the most. Both of those bags also come with crossbody straps, by the way. So if you, and that strap's removable, so if you want to be able to wear it cross body, you can do so. The up, this is nice. You know, I have a love affair with the mini size Givenchy Antigona, and this is covered in their monogram. It's a really thick, tell you what this feels like, Dior book tote material. Really, really thick, all slightly luggagey feeling, really robust. I'm really giving it a squeeze there. It's not losing its shape at all, despite the fact it's fabric. It's got leather trim on it. It's also got, here's what I like. It's got a removable crossbody strap, but this bag is Dior. This bag is trying to be Dior with the, you know, the oblique pattern they've got, but the material they use for it. And also on those Dior bags, the ones where you get a wider strap that's also got the oblique. This bag fits a really good amount. I've put everything in that you saw, including the glasses case, and there is actually still space down in there. And with the leather one that I've already got, you can fit a bottle of water in it, no problem, just in case you were wondering. You're someone who likes to carry water around. Now let's talk about this one that's in the £600 mark. It's this. I have got this in the lilac because this is more of a spring summer colour, but if you take a look at it here, I showed it a while ago now in black. I think if you want something more classic that you can wear with anything, get the black. This is a Givenchy nylon bucket bag. I've said before, what I prefer about this to the Prada version is the Prada version's expensive. It's now £430. This is like 600 and something, so it's only a couple of hundred pounds more. But the Prada one is not a handbag, it's a wristlet, doesn't have a top handle, and it doesn't have the means of attaching one either. This has got a removable top handle and a removable crossbody strap, which really lets you use this bag in so many different versatile ways. If you want to get into any of these brands and you know that you're not going to spend over £700, I think this is a really good one to buy into. Also, the good thing with bucket bags, wow, they fit a lot. Can you see how much is fitting in this? Like, there's a lot going inside it. Take a look, if I can focus, take a look at how much room there is left in this. Like, loads. It's not even full to the top. The iPhone is the highest thing that's going on, the tallest thing that's going on there. It's got a nice decent sized logo on there if you're into your logos. Just a couple more items that I purchased from brands that you'd be surprised about before I talk in depth about all of this. Here are these Balenciaga sneakers. These are like the this is what I mean. You can buy classic items with discounts at the moment. You can get classic items. These I'd seen online, but I wasn't sure about them. I thought they could be a bit much for me, but it was the colour that drew me in. This is an oatmeal colour. I love the tone of it. It's not gym shoe, you know, it's not kind of in a white, or even sometimes a shoe like this, all in black, can look quite clumpy, but it's, I feel like this is perfect for men and women. This is a unisex shoe. So for any of the guys watching, if you like this, I'll link to it below, but it's, anyone can wear them. Also, I thought I would mention Amina Muwadi. Some of you might not know the name, but you might be familiar with this shape of heel from Instagram. This brand is quite a pricey one. I had wanted these shoes for ages, but I couldn't bring myself to spend full price on it. And I actually bought these back in January with a 10% code that Farfetch gave me. This particular style has sold out, but there are loads really similar to it, to be honest, and I will link below to all of the Amina Muwadi shoes. And bear in mind, I bought these with 10% off. You can actually buy them with 15%. I kind of missed out on that. So why are these price rises happening, and why do I really think that if you want to buy anything, now is the time to do it? First of all, I think it's three things. price increases that happen anyway by these brands, the COVID effect, and inflation. And I think those three things are a catalyst for why we are seeing such high price increases and they are so frequent. Let's start with the COVID effect. COVID, even though it is a couple of years ago now, and depending on the country you're in, it kind of, in the UK at least, it feels like we're starting to come out of it. The COVID effect, I believe, is going to take several years for these designer brands to recover from. If you think about it, when COVID kicked in, shops were closed for 3 months plus, and those stores were still having to pay the rent on their buildings, their insurance, their staff. You know, lots of people got laid off, but also the people that were kept on still had to be paid. In addition to that, there was a stock shortage, which pretty much everyone knows about. The stock shortage happened because globally people couldn't work, they couldn't go to work due to isolation rules. You didn't have people making the stock. You also didn't have people making the raw materials that went into actually like a bag. So materials or leathers or metal hardware. So the whole thing froze up all the way back. And I know I went into Prada, the shelves were empty, but they were everywhere. And the lady in there said to me that they did have stock, but it wasn't a lot, and they were keeping it in their back storeroom because she said so many people have come out of lockdown, they want to buy, they want to spend, they want to make themselves feel better, but they didn't have the stock to sell. And she said, if we put everything out, yes, it's going to look like normal, you know, the shelves are going to be stocked, but people are going to come in and buy that stuff, and then we're going to be in a situation where we have nothing left to sell. And as you can imagine, none of these designer brands want that, because then what are you going to do? Close the shop again. So brands had to recover from that. And one of the ways they did it, or the main way they did it, was to put prices up, not just a bit, but a lot. And if you look back at Chanel in 2020, I think they had three price rises in total. And I know that the average, the price rises happened on various different bags, depending on their popularity. And I know that the average price rise for Chanel in 2020 was actually 30%, generally across the board. 30% is massive for all of these things to increase by. And of course, it's not gonna stop people from buying. The next thing is that these brands do price increases anyway, year on year, that's no surprise. And the third thing is inflation. COVID, the way it stopped people spending, and then when everyone went out and everyone went mad spending, that is one of the ways that inflation has really gone up. And those things, which means the cost of living's gone up, the cost of everything's gone up. And that is the final thing in the wheel, which, if you ask me, is the reason why prices have gone up and the reason why so many brands, great brands, are pulling out of any sort of promotions. So many brands are actually burning stock if it doesn't sell, which is gross, and we spoke about that last year. But so many brands would rather destroy stock than sell it for a discount, which is why, going back to my first initial point, now is definitely the time to buy what it is that you want. If you've got the funds available and if you know you want it, now is the time to buy, because prices are only going to go up. Everything is going to be linked to below, including that 15% off. I don't know if I said earlier, but I don't profit from any of the links, and I don't profit from using the 15% off. So if you want to use them, that's just transparent so that you know that I'm not profiting from it. Let me know what you think about this topic though. What do you think about it? Do you think there's other reasons why the prices keep going up? I'd love to know. Thank you all for watching, and I'm gonna go and talk to you now in the comments.